Hey everyone, Anil here and welcome back to another video of Power Apps. So today we are going to discuss leave management system. I already created one leave management system before 3 or 4 years back, and that leave management system having many features, but that leave management system don't have modern controls, modern UI or modern theme. But right now we having modern controls that Power Apps provide. So we are using the modern controls over here, and here also we have extended some features that are not available in my old application. I also created one poll, and where I got like many subscribers said, "Hey Anil, can you please again create a leave management system with modern UI?" So here we go. This is our new application. And these all are the pages that you can see over here. Okay, I will discuss everything in the details today. What we are going to design, and step by step, we will create and design everything, all the screen one by one. So stay tuned, stay connected. Let me describe all about the themes. So here we can see we having on the top, you can see we having all the leaves that a user, a company having, in the policies. So in the company policies, right now I have created 5 leaves type, and all the leaves type you can see here. Total leaves 10, and 5s are available and 5s are consumed. Similarly for casual leave, examination leave, maternity leave and paternity leave. And these leaves we are managing from the backend. So the backend I'm using SharePoint list as a data source. So if I'll show you, we having one list that is company leaves. So here you can see we having all the leaves that we are managing for a company. And if you will see here, these leaves you can see are divided by cadre, senior, junior or management. Okay, and here you can see the total number of leaves, and this is the year. So right now I don't have any filter for the year, but yes, you will get the feature if suppose I have taken only 5 leaves and my 5 leaves are still available, then 5 leaves will be carry forward from 2024 to 2025 or 2025 to 2026 whenever a new year will come up. So that feature is also will be available in this application, but right now that's not available. Alright, then here you can see the applied leaves. So these all are the leaves that I applied. So here if you will see, January 13th to January 14th, I applied a leave and this is the approved leave. Similarly, there are 2 more leaves, 3 more leaves, and one is waiting for HR and one is waiting for manager. And this is the team calendar. My all the teams, that is on leave from this date to this date. And this is the holiday calendar where you can see all the company holiday are visualizing over one card. And this is we are holding over here. Okay. Now in the second screen, if you will see, this is the calendar of my team. This calendar is in a grid view and this is the calendar in a calendar view. So if you will see here, Anil having the leave from 13th to 14th. Again, Anil having one more leave, 15th to 17th. I guess 17th. Then Rachna having one leave, 17th to 18th. And you can see 20 and till 21st. So if you will see here, let me go on leave assignment. And if you will see here, Rachna having the leave from 17th to 21st. 17th to 21st. You can see here. And then if you will see for Nishit having 21st to 22nd, you know, casually, then 23rd to 24th, annual leave. Okay, so if I'll filter for Nishit, you can see Nishit having 21st to 22nd casual leave and 23rd to 24th annual leave. And this was the issue that I uploaded in my last video, that if a user is going to apply two leaves in a week and both leave cannot be visualized in one calendar. But I resolved this issue, and I also, you know, mention the code in the comments. But still, if you are not able to integrate that code in your application, then yes, I will upload a video for that as well. And this video also we are going to incorporate in our Leave application. And stay tuned, stay connected, subscribe my YouTube channel. I will create everything step by step. Okay. And here you can see the name of the user, then this is the ID of the user, you can see employee ID, and this is the title of the user. Okay, title, like we can see what's your role in your company. Okay, and this calendar can we navigate, you know, till nth number. Okay. And here you can filter your leave, like casual leave, paternity, annual, and here you can see like team. If suppose you having any kind of team, and that team you can, you know, bind over here, and you can filter your teams from here. These two features is still not available, but yes, I will create these two features also. And here you can search you know, the user as well. Okay, so right now I think this feature is not available, but yes, in the future, in the future, this feature also will be available, that you can search your team. Now the third is pending and rejected. So this is the approval center. If you will see here, approvals, all the approvals you will get over here. The icons are not correct, but I just uploaded, you know, these icons, but if you want, you can change the icons. So approvals, like I have created one SharePoint list. I'll show you the user details, and in user details I'm managing all the users and who is the manager and who is the HR for that user and what is the cadre for that user. Okay, so whenever a user will be logged in, then we can see who is the manager of that user and who is the HR for the user, because we are going to apply two levels of approval. The first is manager approval and the second is HR approval. So I'm the Anil Kumar and I'm the manager. Okay, so that's the reason I'm getting the approver, the approvals over here. Once I will click on approve, this leave will automatically remove from my system, from my approval center. If I'll click on reject, this will be automatically rejected from my system, from my approval center. I will create one scenario, and step by step, from step 1 to step, all the steps, like how approvals is working, how the leaves are going to be detected from the dashboard, everything I will show you step by step. And here if you will see, here we are, you know, we can see the workflow as well, the approval flow as well. When a user is submitted the leave, when it's gone waiting for manager, when manager rejected, when manager approved, when HR approved, when leave got approved, everything we can see step by step. Might be this data is not correct, because during my testing I created this data, and that's the reason maybe this data is not correct. But yes, right now this application is working and foolproof application. And here you can see edit, delete the leaves as well, but you can see some are disabled and some are enabled. Why was the reason? Because this leave is already approved, cannot be deleted or cannot be modified. If this is waiting for manager, so this is my first waiting, and V4 to approval from my manager, I can edit this leave. I can also delete this leave. And if I will approve, update this leave, whenever I will click on submit, again, it will be submitted. You know, I'll show you. See here. And you will see, you know, this description has been updated. Again, if I want to change, the leaves, and again, if I'll click, you can see this has been again updated. And this is going to captured in my flow. So let me create one leave and I'll show you the approval center as well. So I'll go for Rachna. Okay, so Rachna has taken only one leave, and that's leave, you can see here, the maternity leave. The maternity leave from 3 days and 17 to 21st. Okay, and Rachna is none of the leave is taken by Rachna. So all the, you can see the pie chart is coming in a green. And this is a team calendar for Rachna. And if you will see the team calendar, you can see here as well. So this team calendar is visual for everyone, but here I can see only my applied leaves. Okay, so let me apply one more leave. I'm going to apply the casual leave from here. Okay, so I'm going to apply casual leave for urgent basis, or whatever you want, you can provide your title. So I'm going to apply this from 17th to 21st. Or I can apply, because I already applied this leave, so I'm going to apply 28th to 30th. And this will be a casual leave. Leave description, casual leave, and requested by Rachna and requested to Anil Kumar. And this data is coming from here. Who is my manager? So it will go directly to my manager. Okay, once I will click on the submit button, you can see the leave is coming from here, you know, in my grid, and I can see the status of my leave, all the workflow of my leave, you can see here. Now I will go to the approval center of the manager. You know, one email also will be triggered that, hey Anil, Rachna has been applied one casual leave and it is waiting for your approval. But that email functionality is still not available. I'm working on that. And whenever we will create the video, all the functionality will be here. Okay. So if I'm going to my approval center, you can see here, Rachna is applied this leave just right away. 28th. To 30th, whenever I will click on approve button, approved from or by Anil, click on approved, this leave automatically will remove from my approval center. And now if I will see the status of my leave, then again I will get an email, Rachna will get an email, Rachna, your leave has been approved by Anil Kumar. And here we go, our leave status is waiting for HR. And here you can see the casual leave has been applied for 3 days. Okay, none of the leave is applied, only the casual and maternity leave has been applied by Rachna. Now there is one more feature. If suppose if we are going to apply the leave, and that leave we have applied, you know, for Saturday, Sunday as well. And, you know, if suppose I'm going to apply the leave from 23rd to 19th, then Saturday, Sunday and the Republic Day will be removed automatically, you know, from my leaves count. Okay, so that feature also available in this application. Now, if I will see the data in the grid, in the history of the leave, see here, waiting for manager, waiting for HR, this should be waiting for HR, but somehow this flow is not going to be update. I have to check this, but yes, it was working. There is a mistake, I think. Okay, so the status is waiting for HR now, and whenever a HR will be logged in here. So this is the HR Nitesh. You can see here Nitesh is the HR, and now whenever he will go in his approval center, he will see the leaves that is applied by Rachna. Now if I will click approved by Rachna, or if suppose I'm going to reject this leave, okay, rejected the leave, then what will be happen? My leave automatically will add it in my leaves. So let me just refresh this screen. See here, cancel leave was rejected, and you can see I have my tools leave available now. Okay, and this is rejected by HR. Now what I will do, I will again go here and I will read the comments of my HR. This is not going to update it, I'm not sure, but it was working. I have to check this. But here you can see there is one more feature. I can just click on this button and my application will my leave will be in edit mode, and I can edit my leave. Okay, casual leave applying again, changing the dates. Okay, so now I'm going to apply till 31st. Click on submit. Okay, now it's coming. Something happened, I'll have to check this. Then again, if you will see my dashboard, you can see now again I have 3 days of leave that I have applied, and again it's saying waiting for manager. So this is the complete flow that I have integrated over here. And now if I will see my dashboard, I can see here I have 17 to 18 maternity leave. Then again if we will go into the calendar, see here 28 to 31st I just applied this leave, and this is casual leave, and casual leave you can see here, and Anil having the examination leave. So this is the complete system that we are going to create in our video. And stay tuned, stay connected. I will create everything step by step. And also this system is mobile responsive, but right now this is not responsive, but yes, we will create this system as mobile and tablet responsive. So right now it's a tablet responsive, it's a desktop responsive, but not mobile responsive. I will make it that as well. So I hope you love this video. If you love this video, then please subscribe my channel, and I want 100 comments, then only I will start to developing this video. Until I will not get 100 comments, I'm not sure I will design or develop for you, because I just want to check what is the interest of my subscriber, of my family. If the interest will be high, then yes, I will design this video step by step. Stay tuned, stay connected. Thank you and bye bye.